In Windows, when you try to rename a protected system file, it doesn't let you. To rename a protected system file, you first need to take ownership of it. To do this, right-click on the file and then click Properties, then click on the Security tab, then at the bottom click Advanced. Then at the top next to where it says Owner, Trusted Installer, click Change. Then type in your username if you are using a local account, or type in your email address if you are using a Microsoft account. Then click OK, then click OK. Next click Edit, then click Users, then next to Full Control check Allow, then click OK, then click Yes. Then click OK, and you should now be able to rename the file after clicking Continue then Yes. The method that I just showed works on Windows 11, Windows 10, Windows 8.1 and Windows 8. In Windows 7 and Vista, you right-click on the file and then click Properties, then click on the Security tab, then click Advanced. Then click on the Owner tab, then at the bottom click Edit, then click on your username, then click OK, then click OK, then click OK again. Then click Edit, then click Users, then next to Full Control check Allow, then click OK, then click Yes, then click OK, and you can now rename the file after clicking Continue. In Windows XP, it just lets you rename them. However, as soon as you rename it, another one with the original name appears. To stop this happening, go to Tools, then Folder Options, then View, then under Hidden Files and Folders select Show Hidden Files and Folders, then uncheck Hide Protected Operating System Files, Recommended, then click Yes, then click OK. Then go to the DLL Cache folder, then delete the file with the same name as the one that you want to rename. And now when you rename the file, another one with the original name will not appear. If it comes up with a Windows file protection message, click Cancel and then click Yes.